go. We are back for some more Call of Juarez Gunslinger. The 420 stream still going strong. Without forgiveness.
After my showdown with Jesse, I continued to track his brother, Frank, and that sumbitch Jim. I followed those bastards into the high mountains as they were going to ground.
What mountains would that be?
Somewhere in the Ozarks, I believe. The perfect place to hide out from the authorities. In fact, before I could find them, some Indians who fled the Reds and were hiding out from the military found me first. They probably thought I was a cavalry scout and didn't want me telling the military where they were.
Injuns?
They could have been Cheyenne, but there was all sorts of renegades roaming the landscape back then.
Get no time. Like as soon as they step out, they've got a bead. I'm gonna use my precognition hacks. Are you alive? Not anymore.
Another whiskey, Ben. Nothing better to soothe the troubled soul.
No, not whiskey. Whiskey is bad in a
bottle. Now, where was I? Indians, right. I had more than my share of run-ins with the Red Man. Like that time, did I tell you about Grey Wolf?
The American Civil War, also known as the War Between the States, was a fratricidal conflict fought between 1861 and 1865. On one side was the United States of America, also known as the Union, or the North. On the other side, several slave states seceded from the Union, forming the Confederate States of America, or the South. The North prevailed thanks to its industrial power and advantage in numbers. Civil War was among the world's first truly modern wars, utilizing railroads, telegraph lines, steamboats, devastating artillery, and mass-produced repeating weapons. Of all the wars America participated in, the Civil War reaped the bloodiest harvest, costing the lives of 620,000 men. Its conclusion was also the beginning of the Golden Age of the Wild West. Western expansion increased as railroads brought settlers west at an accelerated pace. The Native Americans were finally pushed from their lands and shunted off to reservations as the cattle business and mining operations boomed. Many of the veterans of the war, damaged by the carnage they saw and participated in, moved west for new opportunities. Quite a few fell into a life of crime. Many rebel soldiers, bitter over the defeat of the Confederacy, continued to fight the war long after General Lee surrendered at Appomattox. They robbed banks and trains owned by Northerners, the James Younger Gang being the most famous example, creating legends which have endured to this day.
Yes, sir. You did.
Of course I did. In fact, I could still remember that old medicine man's words to me.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, we're back to that again.
This hillside looks a little familiar.
great darkness in your heart. It will claim your soul. You will come to this place again and kill many more men.
I noticed that as I stepped out of the tent, I was like, this place looks familiar. Counts hurting. Everything's hurting.
And the darkness will grow until it consumes everything you are.
Doesn't have the range.
So, did you ever find him? Who? The man you are after.
Let me ask you something, Ben. Do you ever think about death?
Mr. Graves, are you all right?
Whoa, game. Easy there. I can't sprint.
Won't you spare me over to another year? What is this that I can't see with ice cold hands taking hold of me? Oh, death. Oh, death. Won't you spare me over till another year?
Okay.
Well, I am death, none can excel. I'll open the door to heaven or hell. Oh, death. Oh, death. Won't you spare me over till another year?
Wow.
Old death, someone would pray, could you wait to call me another day? Oh, death. Oh, death. Won't you spare me over till another year?
Robert Newton Ford, known as the man who shot Jesse James, or as the dirty little coward, is the closest thing to a Judas of the Wild West. This man, who Jesse considered a friend, who let him live under his own roof, shot Jesse in the back, hoping to collect the bounty on the famous outlaw. Robert Ford, in turn, also died from a surprise shot by one Edward O'Kelly, whose only motivation was to become the man who shot the man who killed Jesse James. He succeeded. Robert Ford's was also immortalized in a way by Jesse James's mother, who ordered the following to be engraved on her son's gravestone: "In loving memory of my beloved son, murdered by a traitor and coward, whose name is not worthy to appear here." Such fame isn't worth much, putting Ford in the disreputable company of other murdering cowards like Jack McCall and John Selman Jr.
No wealth, no land, no silver, no gold. Nothing satisfies me but your soul. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Won't you spare me over till another year?
So are you gonna answer the question?
What question is that?
Jim Reed. Did you ever find him?
Reed was indeed that son of a bitch's surname. That's right, Ben. A despicable character. I remember him laughing like a hyena that cold morning they lynched me and my brothers. He was intent on avoiding my vengeance, but nothing was gonna stop me. Nothing.
Jesse James's brother.
I finally did track those outlaws down. They had long rifles with scopes and were well positioned to pick off any poor soul who came anywhere close.
Doing well, too. Apologies for the sudden quiet. That song kind of put a sense of, I don't know what, in me. It sent a chill through me, I'll say that much. I was not expecting that.
I'm guessing Frank James believed I was responsible for the demise of his brother Jesse. I couldn't really disagree with the man, as I thought Jesse was dead then as well. He backed off as I closed in on him, but he was still intent on killing me. And when I closed in on him again, he backed off again, looking for a better angle on me. Hell, I can't fault Frank for wanting his revenge, as I was there for the same damn reason myself. At this point, I'm guessing you think Silas Graves is a worse murderer than Jim Reed ever was.
No, sir.
A man who spent half his life killing somebody's brothers, fathers, sons.
I think you were just looking for justice, sir.
Is that what I was looking for, Dwight? Is that what it was? Justice?
Isn't that why you were hunting the James Gang?
The James Gang. Right. I finally found Frank holed up in his mountain cabin, and he was determined to have me dead.
Get out here and face me!
It was a pitched battle that could have gone either way. Luckily, I had some dynamite in my possession.
Dynamite? On your person?
A few sticks, just in case. It's always good to be prepared.
Right.
I'm just laying out the facts as I remember them, Jack.
And that son of a bitch! Take him out! He's just one man! Put him down! I want that bastard dead!
Fall back for more dynamite. Heave! Ho! Heave!
That old shack? Well, it went tumbling right off that cliff.
With Frank James still in it?
Yes, sir.
But Frank James is still alive, living in Missouri, showing folks around the family farm for 25 cents a tour.
I didn't say he died in the fall, now did I?
I'm done with this damnable outlaw life! Kill me, don't kill me, do what you will! At this point, I just don't give a shit!
I explained to Frank that I had nothing against him personally and that I was looking for someone else.
You want Reed? Have at him. I never did like that bastard. I am done here.
We parted in peace as Frank pointed out the path to my prey before making his way back down the hill.
Alexander Franklin James is remembered primarily as Jesse James' older brother, a guerrilla fighter during the Civil War and a co-leader of the James Younger Gang. During the war, he joined the ranks of Quantrill's Rangers and allegedly participated in the infamous massacre of 200 men and boys in Lawrence, Kansas. He continued his war against the Union by robbing banks and trains. 5 months after his brother's murder, Frank James surrendered to the governor of Missouri, saying, "I have been hunted for 21 years, have literally lived in the saddle, have never known a day of perfect peace. It was one long, anxious, inexorable, eternal vigil. He then ended his statement by saying, Governor, I haven't let another man touch my gun since 1861. To everyone's surprise, he was never sentenced for his crimes. He died at the respectable age of 72. In 1915, after trying his hand at many different jobs, including offering guided tours of the James family farm for 25 cents a pop. Try that.
Incoming fire!
So what happened with Reed?
Well, I finally found the last of the gang hiding in a nearby cave.
How does that work again?
First, I had to dispatch the lookouts. Determined not to let that murderer escape my revenge again.
Shit. Shouldn't have gone down so quick. I should have known. Should have realized. Yes, Red is dead.
But rather than wander in willy-nilly, I decided it would be better to smoke that some bitch out. Hey, Reed! I shouted. No wonder you're so ornery. Can't be easy being married to Belle Starr. While you're off providing for the family, she's spreading her legs for every Tom, Dick, and Cole Younger. Not an attractive woman exactly, but very friendly. At least she was to me.
Son of a bitch!
It was then that the last bunch of bandits jumped out of hiding.
When we think of the Wild West, we imagine cowboys driving enormous herds of cattle, saloons with dancing girls, gunfights at high noon, stagecoach robberies, and handsome heroes coming to the rescue. Every bit of it is sensational, romanticized claptrap. So where did our idea of the American frontier of the 19th century come from? William Frederick Cody, or Buffalo Bill, his nickname earned by slaughtering over 4,000 bison in the course of 18 months to feed railroad workers, sold this picture of the Old West to an Eastern audience, both American and European, with Buffalo Bill's Wild West, a live show combining elements of the circus and the theater. To the audience's delight, Cody recreated various historical events, showcased famous and authentic celebrities, Wild Bill Hickok, Annie Oakley, and Sitting Bull, among others, starred in his shows, and presented iconic situations associated with life on the frontier, employed sharpshooters, riders, and real Native American Indians. It was a perfect, idealized version of the Wild West set to rousing music. Cody had numerous imitators, and attending the so-called Wild West shows became very popular pastime east of the Mississippi. Even outlaw celebrities like Cole Younger or Frank James had their own traveling shows. To this day, American rodeos are not too far removed from those early displays of Wild West derring do.
Eventually, it was just me and Reed.
All right.
I had waited a long time to face him down, so I could repay him for what he did to my brothers.
.384, too slow.
Woo!
Oh, come on. That should have had him. Well, I was bound to run into one that gave me trouble eventually after the last couple that I've done. Welcome back, Lethal. There we go.
And repay him, I did.
Oh. That brings that level to an end. Jim Reed has fallen. Missed one of the nuggets of truth, but that's still not too bad. 4 out of 5. I'm going to go ahead and break this video here. And we will be back for the next one.